Hey guys, this is Stu Murray 47 here, back with another Superman related review. And in today's review, I'm going to be continuing with my DC Who's Who mystery box set. Obviously, the last video that I just uploaded was from Series 1, which essentially showed Superman from one of the Jim Lee covers. Now, the Series 2 sculpts didn't necessarily follow comic covers. They were just very, very cool sculpts, to be honest. That is, I've not been able to find the cover this one is based on. But this is an absolutely great little sculpt that I had to build together. And it basically depicts Superman flying straight into Despero. Now, any of you DC fans out there will probably know who Despero is. Anyone who isn't, basically Despero, and I'll cover this in more detail when I cover my Despero figure, but Despero's one of the main villains, or one of the big villains of the Justice League, and Despero is he's kind of like an alien tyrant, very similar to Darkseid, but on a lesser scale. He's a big, massive red alien. He's got a third eye in his forehead, which he can use for hypnotic powers. But anyway, that's just a very, very brief biography. But this set, of course, came in a little cardboard box, very similar to the Series 1 box. Now, unfortunately, I don't have the Series 2 box to hand, but it was very similar to this. It's kind of like a blind box, to be honest. Whereas Series 1, you can see here, you actually built the Batmobile by collecting all the sculpts. Series 2 actually allowed you to build the Justice League satellite, the Watchtower. Now, the piece that I got with this part is this part here. So this is all I'm ever really going to be completing of the Watchtower. Just an individual piece, of course. Now, what I'm going to do is, before the end of the review, I'm going to show you all the other characters that you would get in this line. But to be honest, of the three Superman sculpts, this one is my absolute favourite. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to give you a quick 360 of the little statuette or figurine, as it were. And you'll see just how cool and dynamic it actually is. So it basically depicts Superman kind of flying at full speed, slamming into Despero's chest, and you can see him kind of wrenching back in pain there. What a great little dynamic statue, and what a brilliant idea. I mentioned on my last review, any of you guys that maybe had Kinder Surprise when you were younger, the little kind of chocolate with the toy inside, this is really similar to that. This comes in about maybe 10 pieces, and you just basically attach it all together. Now, unlike the other one, I'm not going to take this one to pieces, if only because it's only just going to make these more loose, to be honest. But I'm going to show you in more detail. I just thought I'd show you. I just love how dynamic the pose is, that he's flying down and slamming into his chest there. So what I'll do is I'll stop it rotating now, and I'll let you see it in a bit more detail. It looks very, very pink on this light, but it's not quite as pink. So I'll just give you a bit of a close-up there. Obviously, you've got to bear in mind that this is very small, so you've got to forgive the sculpting. But look at that. I love that pose. Look at that Superman flying there. Really, really strong, powerful flying pose. And I love that his cape is all torn, showing that he's really been in a pretty intense battle. Now, Despero is quite a powerful villain, as you can see from the size of him. I'll just give you a bit of a close-up on his face if I can. I love this. I mean, considering that this is kind of just a basic little figurine that you attach pieces together, they've done a great job with the sculpt work here. There you go, just brilliant. So, just to give you a rough idea of how he's built, I mean, in fact, I might actually take Superman out. Superman's just attached by two pegs here in his knuckles. So even if you didn't want to have Despero there, he's got a couple of nipple holes now. Okay, I'll just put him to one side. But you can actually just see, even just this on its own is a really neat Superman figure. And comparing it to the size of my nail, as you can see, it's very small, but the paintwork, certainly on the S, is very good. I don't know about the face. When you look at it in too much detail, he looks a bit strung out from not taking drugs or something there. But as I said, you don't really see it. This is usually the most of the face you'll actually see. But I can't recommend these highly enough. Even the sculpt work on the muscles and the S is, well, that's not sculpted, that's a sticker. But everything else is just brilliant. So, I mean, this is practically one piece. Now, of Despero, his arm comes off as does his other arm, and then he kind of removes from the base as well. But I love that he's kind of bursting up through the ground here. I'll just attach Superman back in again. Get nice and tight. Okay, there we go. And yeah, so this is really just going to be a quick review, unlike the other one where I built the whole thing up. I just thought I'd show you this, but I just think, it's even though I say it's quite small, it's not that small. Well, it is pretty small. but it looks really dynamic. I mean, even if you were to have it up at an angle, on the bottom here, I don't know if I can read this on camera, I think it just says DC Comics 2006 Made in China. Brilliant. Now, the other thing that you do get in the box, of course, you do get a trading card. Now, the previous one showed you the cover it was based on. This one just gives you an image of Despero. And obviously, they've whited out the speech bubble there. But you can see it says Who's Who Series 2. And on the back, it just gives you a bit of a bio on Despero. So basically, I'll just read this. He's a would-be universe conqueror. His alter ego is Despero. Base of operations is Mobile. Height 6'5", but to be honest, I think that's not very accurate because he's massive. Weight 289 pounds. Eyes violet, hair none. It says, a conqueror from the planet Kalanor, Despero possesses an incredible strength as well as a third eye which gives him hypnotic power. With his sights set on eliminating the JLA, he will stop at nothing to conquer the entire universe. So yeah, there's Despero. So yeah, can't recommend this highly enough. If you guys are interested in picking these up, they shouldn't be too expensive. The biggest problem is that I had a bit of trouble on eBay with quite a few sellers where, obviously, it's a blind box. Now, some of the seasons, like Series 1, they have a sticker telling you who's inside. Others don't. And, of course, that's the whole purpose of a blind box. You don't know what you're getting. And there was a lot of people selling Series 1, 2 and 3. And, of course, I wasn't going to buy it if it was going to give me a character I wasn't interested in. But some of them would refuse to open it, which was a bit annoying. But anyway, I managed to find this. There was a seller who had opened them already and showed me this, and it was in good condition. So I was really, really happy to get him. What I'm going to do just before the end of the review then, I'm just actually going to show you the other little statues in this line. Okay, so here's the first figure in this second series, which is another version of Batman, which I think is really awesome. He looks really ripped. He's held up by his cape at the back there. And it's just a really awesome sculpt. I can imagine a lot of collectors wanting to get this one. Love that he's throwing a batarang there. Now, the next figure in the wave, not including Superman, is this awesome Red Tornado. It's a really, really good sculpt. I love the way, obviously, you've got the whirlwind at the bottom there, or the tornado, and you can see him kind of coming out waist height. Just a great sculpt, and once again, I do think that this is probably the strongest series of the three, to be honest. Obviously, here's Hawkman. Now, I think, once again, this is a great, great sculpt. Very, very small, but you can see how kind of ripped he is. He's got a really cool shield in one arm, and he's got his nth metal mace in the other. Very, very cool there. Look at the look on the face there. He looks really angry. You also get a really cool Aquaman who's riding a blue, it looks like a seahorse, to be honest, or a giant kind of sea creature. I think his skin looks a little green in this, to be honest, but I don't know if this picture is very accurate or not. As I said, a very, very strong line, and there's a lot of really cool sculpts to be had here. Look at that, brilliant. He's even holding his trident as well. And the final figure that you would actually get in this line is, of course, Hal Jordan. What I like about this one is it's obviously he's doing his oath, or he's recharging his ring with his battery. It's a nice little change from the Series 1, which is where he's actually getting the ring from Abin Sur. And the final image I'm going to be showing you guys is the kind of the builder figure, as it were, of this line, which of course is the Justice League Satellite. I think this is a little weak, to be honest. It looks like the top of R2-D2 with a little kind of hula hoop around the middle, but it is quite comic accurate for the time. This is obviously what the Justice League orbiting satellite did look like at some point anyway. But as I said, an overall really, really great series. So yeah, can't recommend this line highly enough. Of course, I was only ever going to be interested in Superman, but there are a lot of other cool statues there. Can't recommend them highly enough. So thanks for watching, guys. This has just hopefully just been a quick one. If you guys have any questions or queries, or if you want to drop me a comment, I'd really appreciate it. And I'll see you guys on the next review, which is almost certainly going to be the DC Who's Who Series 3 Superman figurine. Thanks, guys. See you on the next one.